Hello folks, this is BestInSlot and welcome to part one of our Return to Jurassic Park campaign playthrough. Incredibly excited to be bringing you this. Thank you Frontier, as per usual, sending me some early access. Today we're going to be covering the campaign. Of course we're going to have a couple episodes of that, but really the main focus of today after this video is going to be tons and tons of content highlighting every single different aspect of the DLC. So if you want to see all that, stick around on the channel later on. But for now, we're going to get started on the campaign, Jurassic World Evolution, Claire's Sanctuary, and the brand new Return to Jurassic Park. Team up with Dr. Alan Grant, Dr. Ellie Sattler, and Dr. Ian Malcolm in this what-if scenario, tasking you to fix the mistakes of the past and salvage Jurassic Park. I'm pretty bloody excited.
This is so cool!
It gets so much better, Mr. Cabot. Believe me.
I didn't believe you the first time, John.
This is the abuse I'm paying for.
We all have our doubts, John.
But we want to believe. We just need assurances.
What's it like, seeing a dinosaur for the first time?
Oh, it's like, it's like the early days of a new romance. It's fascinating and exhilarating. Until the fangs and the claws come out.
It's definitely a profound moment. It made an impression on me. Let's put it that way.
This is why Jurassic Park must succeed, Dr. Grant. I want the world to have that same profound memory.
You know, I could do without some of the memories of this place.
That's precisely why I asked you all to take this journey again. Had you been part of the process earlier, perhaps our first time around would have been different. A mistake I'm correcting.
We're giving you a chance to prove it, John.
More importantly, we're giving these dinosaurs a chance to live in harmony with the modern world.
However tenuous and unwise that may be.
I'm going to prove it to you all. And Dr. Malcolm, I'm going to prove you wrong.
First time for everything, I suppose.
As you can imagine, everything is a wee bit of a muddle on Isla Nublar, so we'll have our work cut out for us.
Yes, a return to the scene of the crime, as it were.
What crime would that be?
Hubris, John. Something that'll hopefully be managed a little more thoroughly this time.
I admit that I may have been too enthusiastic, and that it may have led to blind spots. That's why I've brought young Cabot Finch along with us.
So, what kind of science are you studying, Cabot?
Business.
Business? Oh, great. The last thing we need more of.
Right, very, very first mission, a brand new thingamajiggy.
After reviewing everything with Mr. Hammond, we'll need to start by placing an arrival point. Then, we can restore the core facilities and get a ranger outpost up and running.
We?
Well, you, actually, Dr. Grant, and Dr. Sattler, and Dr. Malcolm.
Much to do, but it sounds easy enough.
You really are new to this, aren't you, Finch?
Now, it's worth remembering, of course, this is not the first time we've played this. I've already uploaded gameplay from this mission on the channel just the other week. But now I'm doing it live, and actually, you know, I can actually record my voice live as well. Unfortunately, we couldn't do that last time over at the Frontier event. So, there's just one thing I super want to try out. So, you may have noticed I moved over here initially because I was trying to show you this. This is the, let's go to Deptford Field there. the When Dinosaurs Ruled the Earth sign is visible only in the broken version of the visitor center. I just want to see just how far in I can get when using NVIDIA Ansel. It does appear the game isn't going to let me, but what we can do is sit there and go on camera and then feel a view and just take a little peek inside. Look at that! Isn't that cool? Isn't that super cool? When Dinosaurs Ruled the Earth. We're about to again. I'm going to see to that. So, mission one, regaining control. Construct an arrival helipad and connect it to the path network. Not a problem. Arrival helipad. Bingo, blimmin' bango. There's a nice little spot right there. Oopsie, lemony Jesus. I've been playing a lot of Planet Zoo. I have to get back into the swinger things for Joey, as it's known around my condo. Let's just connect those together. Lovely stuff. And we also need to construct and connect a ranger outpost. And I'm gonna, we've got a little bit of power thingy over there. Let's stick that over there. Just like in JPOG, you always want to hide your ranger outposts a little bit off to the side, you know? You don't want them just sitting in the middle. And we'll give this a slightly more security-esque path. Of course, we do have some brand new paths and such, like you can see. Very, again, slightly JPOG-esque, but this muddled, dirty kind of texture, something a little bit more akin to tarmac. And then we've got the fancy path, which has this lovely stony texture on it as well. Most of everything else you've already seen. We've got the signs, of course. These have actually changed since the last time you saw them. So you can see there, that's the new Brachiosaurus sign. It now matches the... this is just tranquilization. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, so they're now green, like they are in the brochure for the film. That's a really cool little detail. Really appreciate that. What else? Yeah, so there they are. These are all the blank ones. Right, you're not powered? Or you're not connected? What a... big ol' nerd you are. Right, come on then. Oh, that's horrible. That's fine, I'll get over it. It's a bit.
You nervous to be back, reasons. Dr. Grant?
You know, last time I was here, I left in kind of a hurry. And I want to make absolutely sure what happened isn't repeated ever again, so I've returned. Reluctantly. On the positive side of the ledger, it's a chance to work with living dinosaurs. Does that paint a clearer picture for you?
Completely, Dr. Grant. And Mr. Hammond seems pretty confident we can get everything working as designed and intended.
Confidence is not something John Hammond lacks. Competence, however,
is something I pride myself in, Dr. Grant. We'll need to repair the geothermal power station to start.
Okay, once that is done, we can focus on the visitor center. Repaired and powered, it should give us a solid base of operations.
God, that's the stuff, isn't it? Oof. Oh, the eye. Oh, everything about it makes me. Oof. Oof, it's a bit much. I need to fan myself. Right. Repair the damaged visitor center. We can do that. Let's get some power to our ranger outpost. And we shall go from. Why don't you have power? Connected over here. Well, we need to get that fixed. So, we're going to hop into our ranger team, which now has a condition meter, you know, because they can be essentially destroyed by the dinos. Let's hop over here. Tell you what, we'll nip around, we'll do this manually. Why not? Go for a little drive whilst we're here. Get the geothermal online. The geothermal plant is actually really cool. I think I'm going to have a video on this by the time you see this, but it's based on a little scene building from the worker area in the Lost World Jurassic Park. Actually, a few of the structures are based on the worker village from Jurassic Park. There's the track. Always wondered why they had a car, person driving the car on the track. I'm hoping we... get a little nod to that. Now the Velociraptor pen should be just down here. There we go. Break. Thank you, love. If you notice there's a lack of music, the only proper sound I'm disappointed by is, you know, when the Frontier text popped up at the start in the orange and red and the very classic Jurassic Park opening, usually it goes, oh, you know, like it does at the start of Jurassic Park and that terrifying little noise. I do have copyright music turned off though, so... it doesn't work, unfortunately. Makes me sad. So, we need a...
You know, I was reluctant to come back here for obvious reasons, but then I realized that I was even more reluctant to stay away because nature would take its course as it always does.
I felt the same. Still, there's no denying this is the single most important place on Earth right now. Perhaps ever.
Perhaps, but... what of Dr. Grant?
He and I are a team. Through thick and thin, you know?
Yes. 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 Still, chaos, Dr. Sattler. Chaos has me contemplating whether we can actually make things better or just delay the inevitable.
It all comes down to responsibility. The last time we were here, we were Hammond's guests. This time, we're more like partners. Now we have the knowledge and the means to make a change.
Ambitious, Dr. Sattler. That's ambitious. But, I do like the sentiment.
Good. I'll need a research module added to the visitor center. Then we can get a look at the different fencing available.
Let's add an emergency bunker to that list as well. I mean, you know, we've both experienced how effective fences have been in the past.
It's actually a great looking little bunker. There's something I want to check super quickly. We saw in the materials for this, it even says it on the Steam page. JPE for color grading. Oh, wow. Really? Is that a noticeable change? Can anyone see the difference? I don't see a difference there. I like that idea, though. Anyways, my point was that they were meant to be bringing in a custom UI, like a Jurassic Park era UI. Now, the only difference I've seen in the UI so far is a couple of changes on the left, of course, to add the new stuff, but also the addition of Mr. DNA to the research screen. I'm hoping that isn't it, that either A, it's not in the game yet, or B, it's something I have to find and turn on. But it doesn't appear to be. I'm wondering what the case is there. That's a little confusing to me. Where's my new UI? I was expecting something quite, you know, big, basically. Anyways, let's get this bunker connected. Just a nice little cheap. Oh, look at that, beautiful. Oof. I actually really like this bunker. It's very cool. Little dudes in there. Worker hats. It does appear the other podcasts have also been edited a little bit as well. If we get a good look at those for the first time, actually. They are. Look at them. Got little... Oh, that's very cool. Little Jurassic Park name tags. And they're actually different from person to person. They don't match at all, because that's actually... I'm actually impressed. It actually does match very slightly. I think it may be just there's a guy one and a girl one, but still, that's pretty cool. I like that. Little detail. Oh, every time. Every bloody time. There's a lot of screaming going on, which makes sense. There are velociraptors roaming around my park.
Mr. Hammond is very concerned. We're getting reports of staff injuries?
Velociraptors? Okay, we have to get them enclosed in the raptor pen.
Aren't you an expert on raptors, Dr. Grant?
I think that it'd be fair to say that raptors and Dr. Grant have history.
Devoting your life to the study of an animal means accepting the harsh truth that it would try to kill you if you ever came face to face with it.
You did come face to face with it.
Which was impossible before Jurassic Park. So that had to count for something.
It did. It counted for a lot of sleepless nights.
No. Eh. No. Ugh. I tried, love. I tried. You're gonna die, but I tried to save you. That's what matters, right? You can take happiness in that before you die. Let's try to get this tranquilizer on. God, it takes so long. It always takes so long. Ugh. Nice. That's some MLG stuff going on there. Right, that is one raptor down. Let's go find the others. Because, of course, we can now tranquilize from the ranger vehicle for the very first time. It's pretty cool. And the flares are actually genuinely helpful. Oh, look, corpses. Maybe not super helpful right now as well, just because raptors are large, but... Oh, you wait until the compies need taken out. There we go. Come on, boy. Come on. Come on. Ah, God damn it. One more. I'm over-educated. There we go. Look at him standing still for me. She, I guess. Making the classic noise that I love so much. Are the other ones on the way?
Receiving initial storm warning.
Whoa! Ooh, she went for a big one there. Ah. And she's out of there. Right, there we go. Now let's get these transported over to the raptor pen. I'm hoping the raptor pen does something again. This is, from what I've seen, the only time you actually use a raptor pen in the entire game. It, other than this, it is basically a decoration. It's a very cool decoration, but still.
So our goal now is get everything under control, right?
Control? No.
Just one sec.
No, Finch. The best you can hope for on Isla Nublar is managed chaos. Okay?
And that is why you are here, Dr. Malcolm.
So, not my sparkling personality, then?
We just need Jurassic Park manageable, chaos and all. Then we can think about larger plans.
John, Alan and I still really aren't comfortable opening the park to tourists.
That is kind of an understatement.
I understand your sentiment and your concerns, but all in due course. And I do seem to remember seeing the public at your dig site in the Badlands. Charged them, didn't you?
Those donations help fund our research.
As did I.
For which we are grateful.
But it's really no different than what we are doing here at Jurassic Park, Dr. Sattler. Just on an admittedly much grander scale.
And with more theatrics. And buttered popcorn.
We all know your vision, John. But the execution, it really needs work.
That is why you are all here. To make sure this dream, my dream, doesn't die.
And there is one other major difference between us, John. In Montana, Ellie and I were pulling dinosaur fossils out of the ground. And here, it's the dinosaurs that are trying to put us into the ground.
And isn't that exciting?
Finch, you really need to learn when to stop talking.
Finch is the greatest character in franchise history, officially. I've got to say, Grant and Ellie actually sound a little odd to me. It's bizarre. I think if you heard them, you wouldn't necessarily actually think it's the real voice actors. It's a little bit peculiar. Malcolm's line reading of buttered popcorn, however, is the best line reading I've ever heard. It's, and buttered popcorn! It's just laced with Malcolmness, which is a deadly drug. Don't take Malcolmness. Yeah, it's peculiar that, but oh, hello, beautiful. I love you so much. Oh, Trikey, you were one of the bottom dinosaurs in the game for me, and you climbed. I want to take you home to meet my mum. She'll be confused. She'll be disappointed I've yet again not brought a girl home, but I brought another dinosaur, but she'll understand. Is that mission one done? Awesome. Now, this is as far as I've ever been. I've never been past mission one. I wasn't allowed to play mission two. All we know about Mission 2 is it involves researching breeding controls. So, this is pretty exciting stuff right now. What are you gonna have us do?
It's still gonna take a while to properly organize and restore the scientific data. Dr. Wu left behind a ton of material.
After Nedry's sabotage, it's a miracle we have anything to work with.
True. But between the storm, the dinosaurs, and whatever Nedry did to the computers, the records and documentation are a mess.
But you think it can be done?
If we can make dinosaurs, then we should be able to sort paperwork and organize computer files.
Can we make dinosaurs? Or are these just impressive replicas?
Oh, they're alive, Alan. And I want them to be as scientifically accurate as possible. Hammond scientists made their mistake by substituting amphibian DNA.
And hiring the wrong people.
But now Hammond has the right ones. Us.
I don't know what he sees in that Cabot kid.
People say that to me about you.
Oh, do they, huh? People. People like Dr. Rockstar.
Oh, I love it. There's a little hint of jealousy coming out again. Ellie and Alan were actually somewhat together during Jurassic Park, and they broke up after the events of the first film because Ellie wanted kids and Grant was still obsessed with dinosaurs. Anyways, we now know that the dinosaurs in the original park were breeding, despite Dr. Wu's best efforts. If we want to control these animals, we're going to have to find a way to stop it. We're going to need data. Some photographic research will be a good start. Use a ranger team to capture images of dinosaurs socializing and sleeping. Don't get close. We don't want to upset them. And this is how we unlock the Jurassic Park stuff for Challenge and Sandbox. So, mission two.
I could use pictures of the dinosaurs. I'll get together a list of specific photos that I need.
Never thought I'd be able to take photos of dinosaurs before. That's a first.
And Alan, the lens cap? I want actual images.
I'll remember. This time.
I love those two crazy kids. Why can't they just get together, you know? They should have been together. Bloody Jurassic Park 3. It's funny, it doesn't actually mention how their relationship deteriorated. The only reason we know what happened in canon is because of like a Topps collectible play card or something like that. And it mentions what happened to their relationship. Okay. Here we go. I'm not going to go any closer. Anyone want to socialize? Anyone want to be cool? No? You are put much nicer with the new skin. So I'm not your biggest fan, you look kind of like a big weird tadpole, but... Oh, sleepy, did we get it? Nice, there we go. I was actually much more worried about that one than the socializing. So the socializing If we just hang around for
Here's
a second.
One for the archives. Great shot.
Doesn't count, right? No. If we just wait a moment, I'm sure somebody will start to have a chat. Right, guys? 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 Do you want a little chip? Oh, galleys are considering it, I think. Does that count? Nope. Look! You all young, hip dinosaurs in the greatest city on Earth. You know, it's time to chill. Do what I command of you. I created you. I can take you out of this world. I brought you into it. It is slightly odd that they've hired... Seriously, I got another sleeping dinosaur. That's socializing, right? Right there? Right there? Come on. Oh, finally? Yes? Yes? Oh, God, that took so long. Legitimately took absolutely ages.
Well, there's a new development. A little photo humor? Because you developed the negative? Oh, never mind.
Big yikes there, Cabot. Big yikes.
All life has two instinctual impulses that no amount of tinkering or engineering, biological or otherwise, can ever hope to overcome. One, survival. Two, reproduction. With man, you can add a third, domination.
Man? Oh, boy. All right, anyway, you're not wrong, which is even more reason we'll need to research a drug to act as a countermeasure to the dinosaurs breeding.
Well, they've had a free run of the island for a while, so we've got to assume that they've been mating. It would be a recurrence plot.
Which is what, exactly?
Although the world is in a constant state of chaos, certain events can be predicted because they happen repeatedly, regardless of the initial conditions. And an organism trying to perpetuate its DNA would be one of those. Or maybe it's the tropical island paradise setting. You know, works for newlyweds.
You know, it could also be the food.
Yeah, perhaps. But considering what some of the dinosaurs have consumed, let's hope not.
Inhibits dinosaur breeding, keeping populations under control. So it doesn't appear, at least at first glance, let's not go either way, it doesn't really appear as though the dinosaurs are actively breeding. I haven't seen any new dinosaurs pop up. I believe these are the same gallimimuses we had since the very start. We can check their age, that would be a good way of finding out. When I remember how, which I will. Age is 6. Is that young or the old 6? They're all 6. So I think we can safely assume the dinosaurs aren't actually breeding, which is a little bit of a shame, but it would also have been... I was optimistic that we'd have got something as part of the campaign, but also I think that was definitely optimism, to say the least. It definitely wasn't likely. Oh, there's a storm. Fantastic. I want to look at the new bracket. The new bracket is beautiful. Okay. Right.
I think we've developed a drug that should inhibit breeding. Dr. Malcolm, can you get a team together to administer it?
Well... A ranger team can shoot them with darts, while I watch safely and securely from a distance.
Do these ranger teams ever do ride-alongs?
You know, for you, Finch, I believe they'd make an exception.
See, Malcolm's got the right idea. He's got nothing to do with this. Why would Malcolm have any desire to go along and tranquilize and medicate dinosaurs? That's not in his wheelhouse. He's just like, yeah, well, I'll get the ranger team to do it, obviously. Right, so we are here for Brachiosaurus. Parasaurolophus, Gallimimus, and Triceratops, and then we'll have to go pick off a Dilo in a little bit as well. Let's give it a go. Yeah, trikey, 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 trikey. Stay there, stay there. Ooh, so close. Bit higher up. There we go. I can hit the bracket from here. Nice. Can I hit the galley from here? Not that one. Okay, that was optimistic, I think. I think we'll agree. So was that. Okay. Hello, buddy. There we go. Just gotta go get myself a galley. I wonder if the flares will work on a gallimimus. I've never tried that. I've only tried it with the carnivores. Give it a go. I'm gonna fire one over there. Storm passing, requesting update. Okay, well, I thought that was going much further. I'll admit. Oh, right here, right here, right here. Careful, careful. Shh. She's a hunter. There we go. Oh no, whoa, no, I just said it, I just meant, nope, wrong, yep. Sorry. Sorry, buddy, that wasn't my intention, okay? I'm just gonna transport you there. Now, just because I'm lazy, I want to get the, where are the Dilos at? You know what, that's not that far away. All I'm going to do is going to chuck a gate in there, and we'll go drive over there. Why not? May as well get involved, right? Let's go, buddy. This way. It's worth noting, this vehicle doesn't have a horn. I'm trying it. It's not working. I'm very disappointed. The horn is my favorite thing. It is a big shame about the copyright music. I do apologize. It's just a YouTuber thing. We really don't have much in the way of an option. I guess I'm at the other side of the fence, right? This side is not as... Oh! Oh, that's cool, though. I want to see this side. Yeah! That's awesome. Oh, I love it so much. Like, oh. What do you think they got in there? King Kong? Should have waited, shouldn't I? Could have done that later. You can actually use that as the tour gate for all of your tour, or you can use ones that look a little bit more like this. I think we can safely say which one we'll be using. Then again, I think only having one Jurassic Park gate is maybe the better way to go. It's a bit more dramatic. I can't get through this tree line. I will find a way. There'll be a route somewhere. I believe this is an all-terrain vehicle. It can swim, it can fly. Oh, there it is. There's always a break in the tree line. Right. There they are. We need another break in the tree line. Don't know how I'm going to get down there. Okay, I'm going to find my flare here. And the Dilos, so fascinated as they are by... My flare has gone on a runner. Why has it left me? I only wanted it next to me. Oh, God, it's over there now. Okay, I'm going to fire another flare. This one's going to stay much closer. All right. You know what? Let's find one here. They look great. I love that. I mean, I have a thing about flares in general. As weird as that might sound. I'm an optimist. What can I say? Tell you what we're going to do, folks. We're just going to do this. There we go, that's how a man does things. Destroy everything in the way. That'll fix it. Alright, let's give that flare. Oh, this is my chance. This is my chance right here. Zoom in. Oh, sure I got that. There we go. Whoops.
It's happening again, Hammond.
No, I won't allow it.
You may not have that choice, John.
Finch, I need to know. Do you have a report?
It looks like the computer systems are under attack. John, we're being hacked.
Dr. Malcolm is correct. The corrupted code has also affected the power grid.
No, no, no.
Don't say the gates are open.
I won't, but they are.
Protection needs to be our top priority. For the dinosaurs and the staff.
I'm staff, right?
Let's get the power grid back. That should help with staff safety.
And I am staff, obviously.
I've got programmers hardening the code as we speak.
Finch, you'll help us get the personnel secured.
Yes, the personnel. The staff, of which I am unquestionably one.
How could anyone not appreciate Cabot? He's amazing. He's like such a quality voice actor as well. Admittedly, young sexy Cabot is a little bit weird, I won't deny. Sexy Cabot is very strange. But it's still Cabot at heart, very clearly. Can I get through here? Yeah, cheeky. Do I have to do all these manually? Because that's insane. I really do. Right, okay. Okay. Fun for the whole family. We'll do this and we'll call it a day. I'll tell you what, we'll call it a day right now. And we'll kick off the next episode, nipping around the park, rebooting. We've been sabotaged by somebody. We don't know who. It's obviously not Nedry at this point in time. So who is it? Who is out there opening gates and screwing around with the park yet again? Is it Biosyn? Or are we going to see some next level industrial sabotage. There's only one way to find out, and that is to come back for episode 2. Like I say, throughout today, I was going to pause this for a second. Throughout today, we are going to have several videos highlighting. We're going to take a look at all the new dinosaur skins. We're going to take a look at the new animations. We're going to take a look at the new buildings. We're going to take a look at absolutely everything. But we will have another episode of the campaign, and then we'll have one daily until the end of the campaign in however many episodes that happens to be. So stick around on the channel, hit the like button if you enjoyed this video, hit the subscribe button, smash that button. Nah, I'm not doing that. Hit the subscribe button if you want lots more Return to Jurassic Park DLC content, and I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers, much love as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.